Harry. Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 6 o'clock. This is Tom Harrigan. A pensioner who killed his terminally ill wife in a suicide pact has called for euthanasia to be legalised. Graham Mansfield was cleared of murder and given a suspended sentence for manslaughter after he told Manchester Crown Court he killed Diane Mansfield in an act of love. Rowan Bridge reports.
The court heard by March last year Diane Mansfield's condition had worsened and she only had weeks to live. On the 23rd, Mr. Mansfield killed his wife before trying to take his own life. He survived and the next morning he rang 999 and admitted to police what had happened. Speaking at the end of the case, Graham Mansfield called for euthanasia to be legalised. Asked on the court steps what was next for him, Mr. Mansfield said, grieving.
The BBC has agreed to pay substantial damages to the former nanny of Princes William and Harry over false claims that she had an affair with the Prince of Wales, which led to an abortion. The High Court heard it was likely that the totally baseless allegations against Tiggy Leg Bork, now known as Alexandra Pettifer, were presented to Princess Diana in 1995 to convince her to be interviewed by Panorama. The BBC has apologised. The head of the inquiry into the COVID pandemic has promised it will happen as speedily as possible so lessons can be learned before another one strikes. Lady Hallett said preliminary hearings would begin in September. Dame Deirdre Hine chaired a review of the swine flu pandemic. She says only one or two of her proposals were implemented.
The one that they didn't implement was the one where I said that there would be, in all likelihood, a much more serious pandemic in the years to come, and that the resources required should be thought about very carefully. Clearly, that didn't happen.
Liz Truss has attacked the economic policies of all British governments over the last 20 years, saying they failed to deliver growth. A new YouGov poll has put Ms. Truss 24 points ahead of the former Chancellor Rishi Sunak in the final vote among Conservative Party members to choose the next Prime Minister. A senior economist at the Institute for Fiscal Studies, Stuart Adam, says those members face a real choice.
Liz Truss is proposing more than £30 billion of tax cuts relative to what Rishi Sunak is proposing, which is more or less continue with current government plans. Really, she is looking to shake things up much more than Rishi Sunak.
President Biden is experiencing very mild symptoms after testing positive for coronavirus. The White House says the 79-year-old will work in isolation and is taking antiviral medicine. Mr. Biden is fully vaccinated and had two booster jabs. Beavers are to be given legal protection in England, meaning it will be illegal to kill or harm them. The rodents were hunted to extinction 400 years ago, but have reappeared in a number of rivers in England and Scotland because of official trials, escapes and illegal releases. The weather, it'll be cloudy tonight with a few showers around, drier to the far north and west. BBC News, it's 3 minutes past six.
Tom, thank you very much. I've swam with a beaver, you know. True story.
When there's someone by your side to sing,
life's a happy song.
When there's someone by your side to sing,
life's a happy song. When there's someone by your side to sing along.
We are by your side till seven, then it's Jo Wiley with her shiny happy playlist. Yes, I did a wildlife show with Gordon Buchanan and I swam with a beaver. Down in deep is Dartmoor. DJ in Beaver Shocker in Dartmoor. See the headlines now. Tonight's MPD.
Hiya, Sarah. This is Dazza from Farmworth. We're having Red Hot Texas-style chilli on this nice warm day.
Very nice. Thanks, Gazza in Farmworth. Tomorrow with Breakfast, Zoe chatting to Daisy Edgar-Jones about where the crawdads sing.